Working out a facade of this shape was a challenge, and in case of the interiors, availability of very little natural light led the architects to go for a color scheme of beige and bronze.
The idea was considering the area that where Aerocity 1 is placed in. You're targeting, it's not placed in the major areas like Worli or somewhere. So of course we needed, the client wanted that look, but of course in a cost effective and a budget. So there are companies such as Kooton etc. who's supplying tiles which are as big as 4 feet by 8 feet and are giving you the look of a marble. So that was the entire idea behind it. So we selected tiles from these companies where the look was and the feel was of a marble. So some tiles that were selected were similar as what a Brescia Aurora marble is. Some were selected what a Danish creme marble is. Some were selected as antique beige and the Irish brown marble is. So it depended on
basically
the variety.
The total idea was only to go in beige and bronze. Okay. Because there is hardly any natural light. That was the main question. The natural light we have taken from the sky roof. So that was the main idea that any dark color we go, the space will look much
even
smaller.
More darker, right. Even more right. Smaller. Right. So that's one of the reasons. There were lighter pastel shades. Mm-hmm. In some patches we've used a little dark just for the contrast of it. Right. That was the idea behind it.
That's so why the ACP is also, you must have noted, we have gone for light camel type tone.
Matte
finished, your rustic series,
exactly.
Aludecor's rustic series. So giving it simple yet elegant look, that's how our taste is, that's how we go about it. And of course with the budget constraints, the tiles kind of were helping us to give that, achieve that look, you can say. So that eventually of course their builders, they want to sell them. So it has to attract the end user so that they can buy and purchase at a decent rate. So that was the entire idea behind it.
The atrium serves multiple purposes, including interacting with clients visiting.
That area is at the time of the lunch and all. We are trying to create a coffee shop. So people sit around,
they're interacting with
each other, interact along with each other. And otherwise when the office are occupied and coffee shop is there, so people come and sit over there, discuss it out.
Even it's a waiting area, come a discussion area. So of course, I mean, it's a building which is comprising of more than 250 offices. So you're going to have common kind of links up with these offices that day. So even the people who are residing within that can also interact with one another, or even say if office number XYZ has a couple of clients who have come over, and these offices aren't the big scale offices, you know. There are some offices which are as small as 500 square feet which can barely accommodate the staff.
500 to 2000.
Okay. Right?
That's the basic.
So, now suddenly you have a couple of clients or people whom you want to meet up. So, okay, fair enough. You don't have that space in office. Okay, we've created that space for you downstairs where we've kind of made the atrium into a coffee shop also. So, you can entertain the clients. You can have an interaction with them. We've provided them with all the facilities that they would need to do a kind of a business meeting. So all of that can happen within that space. Now, creating that as the highlight of the entire interior was the simple reason. You're getting a height of close to 120 feet high, that's 10 stories above. Creating a skylight above was the main idea, that at least there should be some scope of natural light coming in. And that's the reason the entire atrium was designed accordingly. So we selected the polycarbonate sheets accordingly, and the petal shaped design of the Absolutely. Steel truss that was there, that was entirely done in a petal shaped format.
To make the otherwise asymmetrical interior look, symmetrical was challenging too.
The the building shape is not symmetrical at all from inside. You might have noted, I don't know. The shape is very funny. So it was a really task for us to give that feeling.
From the interior to make it look symmetrical,
exactly,
was a tedious task, simply being
a big task.
Because the structure is actually, it's in a V shape that keeps increasing on every floor plate as you rise above. Now what happens is the atrium does not go that way. The atrium goes parallel. But how to make that look even from all angles. So that was kind of a tedious task that we had to achieve. But
it
then,
is not pentagonal. It is not a rectangle. It's not a triangle. The shape goes like this, then turns like this. Here it doesn't turn. Here it turns.
Right.
So it's very asymmetrical.
It was a little very funny, you know, shape when we came into the picture.
Okay. So to give an illusion to an asymmetrical space.
Right.
Exactly. Absolutely.
That's the idea.
Absolutely.
That's the reason if you've seen the corridors, we've not chosen tiles having a specific size onto it.
Okay.
We went with the wooden finish planks, mm-hmm. which are 4 inch by 1200. So that's close to 100 mm by 1200 mm. So we laid them randomly. So that the corridors which are going in asymmetrical manners, you don't have these abutting joints of tiles in a very haphazard manner, which kind of are an eyesore. So we kind of created a very random pattern with these planks, and we laid them throughout the flooring of the atrium. So that was the key idea doing behind it.
You never see any funny joints.
Mm-hmm.
Even in the atrium, if you see, we have played like a chess pattern.
Okay. The main atrium, yeah. We've done that with 1200
reason.
by 1200 tiles.
That was the main reason,
right.
By playing a chess tile design and border we created in one color.
Oh, right.
So in chess pattern you won't feel where the tile is gone, two tiles have symmetrical or one tile is symmetrical. In chess pattern you are standing on any floor.
Mm-hmm.
You will feel absolutely perfect. You will not feel something is gone wrong somewhere.
Yeah, so idea was to create with a lighter tile and a darker tile. Now if you create only light, that's going to look pretty monotonous, and darker tile would get a little too jarring. So that's how we came up with the chess pattern module, so that a person who's standing maybe a couple of floors above and is looking at it, it gives him that kind of a rhythm that is there on the flooring below. It's not something too drab, which is like a very light color that's just flowing throughout in glossy finish. It's a mix and a blend of both. And kind of created the darker pattern running at the perimeter so that all the joints that are being cut in acute or obtuse angles get avoided. So all you see is the 1200 by 1200 checkered pattern throughout the center. That's the main idea.
And the side tiles are dark. So there the tiles is cut, you won't be able to know.
Okay.
One can't notice that would make it.
So you won't be able to notice on that point of view. And reception when you enter the lobby, when you're entering, we are taking the dark tile. So that tile merge with the dark tile of your atrium.
Mm-hmm.
So there also the joints are there,
mm-hmm.
but you can't make it out.
Because the entrance reception that he's speaking about is purely a rectangle,
mm-hmm.
but the atrium is way more than an octagon or whatever you want to call it further above. So yeah, I mean merging those junctions, those corners, that was a tedious task.
It was a big challenge.
But kind of I think we've achieved it. Decently I can say it. Decently. That's how we can say it. So the rustic series of Aludecor that was selected was again, it's very pastel. It speaks for itself. It's not flat. It has a certain texture to it. So it kind of adds the rhythm to the entire atrium. Now see, we're talking about going 10 floors above. You're talking about a height of, if I'm not mistaken, was almost 4 feet. So 4 feet of the ACP, the band that was running across.
Correct.
The crystal-like shape and different types of surfaces of the facade posed a challenge in terms of execution.
Yeah, I think it is a challenge in terms of installation.
Okay.
So because of the shape. So
it's being a crystal shaped.
Yeah. So it's got different surfaces. So generally it's not, you know, there are slopes, there are turns, there are kinks. So it is a challenge in terms of even procurement. In terms of wastages, in terms of all that. So I think that was a challenge. Basic challenge was in terms of not execution in the sense, not in terms of designing something. Designing was easier, But the problem is the execution and procurement of the materials.
The building has adequate fire safety measures as well.
I would say first is life safety is a major concern, which, you know, right now there are so many fires which have happened, and I think appointing a consultant, an architect, international architect and a consultant, they normally look at these are the factors which they is mandatory. So we go as per codes and all that stuff. So if you look at this, the starting from the curtain wall, you have a fire safing which is 2-hour fire rated. So you have a system which is UL rated. That is one. The ACP which is used is fire rated. So that is mandatory because we don't compromise on that. And rest, they've got, I think, sprinklers, they've got active measures also, and they've got, not a refuge, I would say more of a fire escape staircase, and they've got even lifts which are fire lifts in the building.